And the fire department talking about how important it was to have Maui firefighters, the Maui County firefighters from Lanai that helped them get to that kind of remote area within 12 minutes. And I think we have our Andrew Pereira is just near that crash site in an area called Miki Basin. So we'd like to head over there and have Andrew Pereira live on Lanai. Andrew, what can you tell us?
Yeah, Paula, this is the Miki Basin area of Lanai. This is former pineapple land, so very rugged. As a matter of fact, we saw several axis deer jumping around here as we were trying to locate this crash site. It took us several minutes to locate the crash site. That's how remote of an area it is. And after this Piper twin-engine PA-31 went down, also known as a Navajo, it crashed in this remote site. You can see the police car here behind me. And just beyond that is that's where you actually have the crash site, that second tent beyond me. Now, Goodfellow Brothers and Palama Lanai actually brought out some heavy machinery late at night and cut a path, about a 600-yard-long path, to that crash site, assisting first responders and getting to that crash site. Now, we're coming up on about 15 hours since that Piper twin-engine aircraft went down, and just a few moments ago, a palpable moment when those two county workers that were killed, their bodies were pulled out of this wreckage along with the pilot. As you've been describing, one of the workers, we're told that both of the workers are females. One of the workers described as a longtime worker for the Maui Planning Department, just about 5 years away from retirement. She talked at last night's meeting before the Lanai Planning Commission how she was looking so much forward to retirement. The other victim from the Maui Planning Department is described as the person that kept all of the minutes during the meetings, that kept everything in order. So a secretary type position that logged everything that went on during these meetings. I've been hearing from folks on Lanai who say they are very moved by this crash, even if they didn't necessarily know these folks who perished in this terrible plane crash. They say that in such a small community such as Lanai, only about 3,000 folks on the island, they feel the pain of the families back in Maui who are, of course, mourning a tremendous loss. Now, what we've been able to do is we've been able to verify the tail number of the aircraft and look through FAA records. We have seen that the aircraft was manufactured in 1975. It belonged to a company known as Maui Tours. It was chartered by Maui County to bring the workers over here for that Lanai Planning Commission meeting, and that meeting wrapped up at 8:30 because they had to catch their flight home. We've been talking to many people, and so far there are no reports of anyone hearing anything that would resemble engine trouble or anything of that sort. I've been told that it was very windy on Lanai last night, but of course we don't know if that has anything to do with it. We're going to step out of the way here, as we do believe that these are the bodies of the three victims being ferried out right now. Folks here on Lanai say that the folks that perished have been with them for the last year, putting together the community plan here for Lanai that involves all sorts of infrastructure, all kinds of planning, and folks here on Lanai got to know them very well. And we'll take a pause here as the victims pass us by. Again, you can see very rugged terrain. You can see the path that heavy machinery cut to get to the crash site. And we've been told that the FAA and the National Transportation Safety Board officials from both of those agencies are en route to Lanai. They will be examining the crash site, looking for any debris that may have fallen off of the aircraft. The aircraft went down about a mile southeast of the runway at Lanai Airport, and so they will be going through this area, as difficult as it might be, with a fine-tooth comb, seeing if they can find any clues as to what brought this plane down. We expect an initial report probably within a week from the National Transportation Safety Board. However, it may take as long as 6 months or more for the NTSB to come out with its final report that shows what may have have caused this plane to go down. We do know the names of all the victims involved. However, we are not releasing those names at this time out of respect to the families. And we've been told that the pilot is a man possibly in his 50s or 60s who has been on these charter flights, has piloted these charter flights before, as these folks make their way to Planning Commission meetings here in Lanai. And as I step back into the picture, really all that can be said is that this is a tragedy on two islands. Folks on Maui County, as you heard, feeling the pain of the families, and folks here on Lanai who got to know those folks very well. And then let me add one more thing, and that is the Deputy Corporation Counsel is being hailed as a hero here, as you heard in that press conference. Folks here just giving a lot of kudos to that gentleman for not only having the wherewithal to drag two victims that are in critical condition out of that burning wreckage, but also calling 911 and letting them know that he was on a plane that had just gone down about, again, a mile southeast of Lanai Airport. Paula?
All right, thank you very much, Andrew Pereira, live at the scene on Lanai, where that Piper went down just a little after 9 o'clock last night.
And you can see in his live shot right there, and as our camera was panning around, you heard from the assistant fire chief how high the grass was. You can see the conditions that the emergency crews actually had to go through to get to the wreckage. And we heard in that press conference on Maui that the plane was fully engulfed in flames at the time when they got there.
The fire department had to put out that fire before they could get to the victims who were still in the plane. Of course, as Andrew talked about, that Deputy Corporation Counsel who had helped to bring two of the survivors off the plane. So we'll be hearing a lot more of that, stories from the island of Lanai and from Maui and Maui County.
Yeah, we will continue to cover this breaking news for you on air and, of course, online, KITV.com. We continue again to cover this story for you throughout the day. Our next newscast coming up today at 5 o'clock. But right now, we're going to send you back to programming.
Aloha.